It's Professor Monti. Let me show you how to graph a function and its inverse. Okay, the basic idea is we reflect the graph of f, the original function, over the line y equals x to get the inverse function f inverse. Okay, so pick some points and swap x and y if you need. Let's do some examples. So graph f of x equals 2x plus 1 and its inverse, f inverse of x, on the same axis. So notice the graph of f of x. Well, f of x just means y. So if I'm just thinking y equals 2x plus 1, I can graph that line. Let's just plot a couple points. Let's see. If x equals 0, 2 times 0 is 0 plus 1 is 1, y equals 1. If x is 1, 2 times 1 is 2 plus 1 is 3, y equals 3. So I've got the point 0, 1, and I've got the point 1, 3. Okay, so 0, 1, 1, 3. Those are on my original function. Let's graph that in blue. So here's my f function. There's f. I can get the line y equals x, which is just this dotted line going up through here, y equals x. So it goes through 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, etc. And it's the reflection across that. Now, if I need help, let's just swap some of these points. So we'll do this. I'll do this graph in red. So I had 0, 1 for my function. So for my inverse, what I'm going to get is I'm just going to swap x and y. So instead of 0, 1, I'm going to have 1, 0. Instead of 1, 3, I'm going to have 3, 1. And so I've got 1, 0. I've got 3, 1. And it's going to be the graph through here. This red one is going to be f inverse. And notice what happened. They cross, this point of intersection is right on this line y equals x, because where the x and the y are the same point. But instead of 1, 3, I have 3, 1. Instead of 0, 1, I have 1, 0. And so these graphs are inverse to each other. Anytime I go straight across this y equals x, these are going to be the same distance away. So now I've got a graph, given the graph of f of x, this blue graph, graph f inverse of x. I don't have an equation. I don't have points. I can kind of guess what the points are, but I'm going to do this other trick. I'm just going to reflect over the line y equals x. So the line y equals x is going to go straight up through here. And I know since this point's on the line, I'm going to have that as one of my graphing points. So that's going to be a point on f inverse, and it's just going to look like this. This may be, say, negative 2, 0. Well, if this is, for instance, maybe negative 1, 0. So I'd have 0, negative 1. So notice, go straight across that line at whatever angle I need to make that a 45-degree angle. I'm going to have the matching point over here. Well, I've got this point. I knew it had to go this point. So now just graph those, and that's going to be f inverse. So that's it. That's not part of the graph. That's just showing you where the point is. But the graph of it and its inverse are just reflections across this line y equals x. Again, goes through 0, 0, 1, 1, etc. Or you can just swap some points if that helps. So whatever way, they're always going to be reflections across the line y equals x. And so you can just swap points if needed, or just draw the graph straight away.